Hi, I'm Ian Small. I'm CEO of Evernote, and I'm here today with Mariano, who's one of the members of our design team. And we're going to talk a little bit about what Mariano's been working on. So Mariano, what problem are you trying to solve for our customers?
Right now I'm working on the search experience for the new Evernote Web, because currently we have a very basic version and we're trying to make it more powerful and streamline the search. We're creating this very interactive experience where the second that you focus on the search box, we're going to open this overlay that's going to show you a number of suggestions. Some of them are going to be recent or suggested searches. Some of them are going to be notes or notebooks that you can jump directly to. So as you're typing, these suggestions are going to change. Literally for every character that you enter, you're going to get different suggestions.
So today in the web version, the search is basically, I go to the search box, I type in some words, I hit return, and then I get search results.
Correct.
This is different. It looks like as soon as you start typing, you're getting things back interactively. So let's say you decided meeting notes was what you liked.
So you would select it using your keyboard or mouse, and you would jump to a screen that's going to look like this, where you're going to see a number of results that actually match those keywords.
And I see they're all highlighted in this nicely designed yellow highlighter color. That seems a lot better than what we're doing today.
Yes, so that's something that we heard from our users, that they see a number of results, but they have no idea why. So we want to make it really obvious.
And I notice if I look at this list that the first one has a hit that's in the title of the note and in the body of the note. The next four are all in the title and then the body. This looks like we're making the title more important.
Yes, we have a very smart team of engineers working on an algorithm that's going to prioritize those matches so that, you know, the one that's hopefully more meaningful for you is going to show up first.
That's cool. So it's not just about making the interface easier to use and more powerful. It's also about actually reworking the algorithm that sits behind generating the searches.
Exactly. So this is showing another thing that we're going to do, which is adding filtering capabilities to the search experience. Filters are basically ways of narrowing down the list of notes. So for example, who worked on those notes, or when they were created, or where are the contents of those notes? Like, for example, did you add images or voice notes or attachments and so on? So in this example, you type in ME, and you actually have a tag called Mexico, and you also have a person called Melinda that worked on your notes, so you see her as a suggestion. Let's pretend that you go ahead and select Melinda because you want to see the notes that she worked on.
Okay.
You're going to jump to this screen where Melinda has been added as a filter, and therefore you see it a list of notes that Melinda has worked on.
But I see you're still in search at this point.
Right, because we want to create this experience where we still give you a number of options to continue to narrow down the list of notes. So, for example, you might remember that you worked with Melinda on something maybe during last year or this year, that the note contains an image or a PDF attachment and so on.
And so you can keep selecting these and narrowing the set. So this is a pretty comprehensive rework of the experience that exists today on the modern web version of Evernote. Where did all this come from?
So we went through all the different experiences that we have on mobile and on web and on native clients. We talked to a number of users. We saw what's happening on forums. We also saw what was happening on the industry. And we combined all those different sources into this new experience. And we're trying to establish a new pattern that we're going to implement across the board.
So we're looking at pretty pieces of paper here, and they're very pretty. Is this just mock-ups?
These are already, you know, out of the design oven. They have been handed off to the developers that are currently working on this as we speak, literally.
Thanks very much for sharing this with us. I think it's great. It's part of showing you the journey that we're on to try to make Evernote better. Better for you, and a better experience that all of us can use together. Thanks very much, and we'll see you next time.